Hello everybody and welcome to SnackTube. Today's item is one that I picked up in my local supermarket in their foreign food section. Very similar to a lot of items that I've reviewed on here in the past. That's right, it's noodles again. But this time I've got some Nong Shim Shin Kimchi. So these are apparently kimchi flavoured noodles. Kimchi is a Asian-y kind of thing. These ones in particular are from Korea. Seoul, Korea, as it were. So, yeah, I figured I'd get these ones for you guys so I could try them and see what they're like. I do enjoy a nice bowl of noodles, a nice ramen or a nice noodle soup, so hopefully this should be good. So, yeah, that's your serving suggestion there, your bowl, and I'll show you mine in a wee second. Now, let's read a little bit about this bad boy, shall we? So, it's a... The bag itself is 120 grams, which is 105 grams of noodles, 12 grams of seasoning powder, and then 3 grams of vegetable flakes. Does it have a description? Basically, the description just says instant noodles kimchi flavour. So, pretty straightforward. Now, I was looking at the ingredients earlier, and I'm not going to go through them all, but I just found this quite interesting. Because remember, these are kimchi flavoured noodles, right? So the noodles themselves are 87%. Wheat flour noodles, and then you've got all the usual stuff, a bunch of E numbers, a bunch of preservatives. The seasoning powder is 10%, which again, fairly typical stuff, spices, garlic, salt, pepper, that kind of stuff. And then your vegetable flakes are 3%. Kimchi Chinese cabbage flakes. So the actual kimchi in this is only 3% of the thing. So either it's going to be very strong or it's probably not actually going to taste like kimchi. And then you've got pak choy, carrot, and green onion. So that's your vegetables. It's quite interesting as well. It may contain barley, crustaceans, eggs, fish, peanuts, milk, celery, sesame seeds, and mollusks. So they obviously don't take a lot of care to make sure that all the stuff is separated in this factory. But hey, I've not got any allergies or anything, so for me it's okay. I just kind of feel bad for anyone that has any of those allergies. They basically have to stay away from this, even though it doesn't have any of those things in it, apart from wheat. So yeah, but anyway, let's read a bit about our nutritional value, shall we? So this gives you a pair 100 grams. Now, of course, this is 120 grams, which I wish they would just give you a pair 120 grams. It actually ends up being more than that once you add the water, because you have to add 500 milliliters of water. So you've got a pair 100 grams, 427 calories, which would make this thing probably around about 500 calories, which is pretty hardy bowl of noodles, so I'm not complaining there. 13 grams of fat, 6.5 grams of that saturated, so quite high in the saturated fats. That's definitely over what it should be, given it's a quarter of your calories. 68 grams of carbs, of course it's noodles, 4.9 grams of sugar, 9.6 grams of protein, so a decent amount of protein, considering. And then 4.5 grams of salt, that's half your salt, and that's only for 100 grams. So per 120, that's more than half your salt for the day, so better be flavourful, let's be sure for that. Right, yeah, these are manufactured by Nong Shim Co. Limited in Seoul, Korea. They have a Facebook page if you want to go on and check them out. So it's a product of Korea. Now to make these, you basically just add the noodles and the packets to 500 millilitres of water. So I'll show you what came in the packets. So obviously it came with the noodles. They came in sort of a disc shape, which is quite interesting. And then it came with the pack here of flakes and a pack of the soup base, so the sort of soupy seasoning stuff, the stock, as it were. And yeah, it's very, very red. So that's your serving suggestion there. And then I'll show you the bowl. I'm not going to lift the bowl up. I'm going to just lift the camera, and you, I should just say I'm not wearing any trousers, so you might see my underpants, okay? There they are there. So yeah, that's what it looks like. It's pretty similar to the packet, apart from the amount of kimchi. I would say the amount of vegetables is a lot bigger on the packet. A bit more pronounced, but there you go. Now, like any other noodle soup or noodle thing that you get like this, you know, you can add anything to it. You know, if you want to make it a chicken thing, you could add chicken to it. You could add seafood to it to make it a bit more of a meal. So these things are very versatile, which is why I like them. But quite frankly, just eating them as they come, they're generally quite good anyway, and it's great for a lunch, for sure. And this is my lunch for today. Don't know what I'm going to do for dinner yet, Probably not something I'm going to review. I'm going into town to watch a wee film, so I'm thinking I might have a wee Taco Bell. I should try and review a Taco Bell on the channel. Like, I can't get Taco Bell delivered here, though. That's the only problem. Anyway, let's give this a wee try. So it's got a lot. There's a lot of the soup, and then of course there's the noodles. So I'm gonna try the noodles first. They're all very well connected, so I'm just getting big strands. I really need to get some chopsticks, because I don't have any chopsticks in the house, and it'd be more authentic if I had some chopsticks with these. Right, let's do it then. So these are the Nong Shim Shin Kimchi noodles. Let's give them the old taste test. You gotta slurp your noodles, boys. And girls, boys and girls, you gotta slurp your noodles. Get a bit of the soup. Just gonna lift the bowl up and get a bit of the soup, shall we? Okay. Right, so before I review this and tell you what I think of it, I'm just going to mention, because I forgot to mention it earlier, I actually have a secret mystery item in this video that I'm going to review at the very end. So don't leave until the end of the very end of the video, because there's one more thing you're going to get to see, and it's not going to appear in its own separate video, so stay tuned. Right, so the kimchi noodles. I wouldn't say there's any major flavour of kimchi, to be honest. I mean, does kimchi really have much of a flavour? It is just kind of a cabbage. And I like cabbage, fair play. So it maybe adds a bit more substance to it if you had a bit more of it, but you can't really taste the kimchi. The noodles are good. They are very, very nice. They're sort of thicker noodles, almost udon. Maybe not quite as thick as udon noodles, but yeah, not far off. So they're thick and they're kind of chewy, and perfectly cooked. So they're really, really good. I'm trying to describe the flavour of the soup. Let me just have another wee nip. Sort of like it's kind of like a vegetable-y stock. Very slight fishiness to it, maybe, but not enough to notice that it's really fish unless you're really looking for it. Quite spicy, quite a lot of spice to it, so it's very, very, very kicking in the back of the throat and in the back of the tongue. I'm just wondering what that is, because it's not supposed to be a particularly spicy one. There's black pepper in it, spices, but apart from that, you can taste the garlic. I would say that there is a decent flavour of garlic in it. Yeah, very much taste the garlic. So it's sort of garlicky and kind of spicy, for sort of vegetable-y stock flavour. It's really nice. It is really, really nice. I don't know if the flakes really add much to it, because there weren't a lot of them. I think if you put some chunkier vegetables through this, to add a bit more substance, that'd be pretty good. But the soup is nice. It's sort of garlicky, spicy, salty, very salty. As you would expect, given the amount of salt in it. Those noodles are brilliant. They've got a lovely bit of bite to them, which is what you want in noodles, a lovely bit of bite. It's horrible when you get noodles and they just turn into mush. Okay, and those are definitely not mushy. They've got a good, decent amount of bite to them, but they're not crunchy or anything. That's why I love thicker noodles. They are definitely better. Yeah. Very nice, very nice. I love that. Very good flavour, and the noodles are fantastic, and they're very cheap as well. I believe this was like less than a pound, so well worth the money. I don't know so much about it being kimchi. I'll need to try some other flavours and see what they're like, but very tasty. Right, well, that's everything about the kimchi shin noodles. Now about that wee mystery item. I did put it in the title of the video, so you maybe guessed that I've got a mystery item already. But the reason I've decided to do this as a mystery item and not its own separate thing is because I have no idea what it is. This is something that my mate Hall got me. These little bad boys. So I think they're like little chocolatey flan cookies. But the box is all in Japanese. There is no English on here at all anywhere. So I can't tell what they are. I can't tell what's in them. I'm just kind of assuming that they're like little biscuits or little chocolates. So there they are there. Let's break open the packet. It's got a nice foil seal. Ooh, they look like, yeah, they're like little chocolates. They smell good. Because they look like flans, right? They look like flans, and flans are sort of made of custard. Look how tiny they are. Wee toty wee flans. Let's give this one a little taste test then, shall we? Those are good. They're sort of, yeah, they're sort of chocolatey and they've got a kind of custard flavour. Which makes sense, seeing as they're little flans. These ones don't have little faces on them like they do in the packet. But, lovely. That's a lovely wee snack. Delicious. Well, I'm not going to fill up on them just now because I've still got my noodles to finish. So, I'd recommend them. If you see them anywhere, they are very, very nice. Custardy. Custard-flavoured sweets. I love custard-flavoured sweets like drumsticks. Absolutely lovely. Right, well, I'm keen to get off and finish the rest of this kimchi ramen because it, or kimchi soup or whatever it is, because it's lovely. So, thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, give it the old thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel and hit the wee bell to get notifications anytime one of my videos comes out. And I've got a TikTok now, so you want to head over there and watch that. And of course, follow me on Instagram and all the other stuff. That'll do for today. Thank you very much for watching, and I will catch you all in the next video. I'll see you then.